Good morning, my name is Dr. Chadha. I am speaking to you from Dubai, and today I'd like to talk on an interesting subject. It's called belief and faith. This is something that we all human beings, man or woman, anywhere in the world, experience. What is the difference between belief and faith? First, let's understand what is belief and let's understand what is faith and how we relate with these. Belief is something that we believe in. It could be with the five senses that are giving information to us. Most of the things that we believe have come to accumulate into our common sense, and our common sense has been built from the age we were born till the age of 18 by ourselves. Common sense is not taught, it's not a subject, it's not given, but it is something that we believe that this is the right thing or this is the right way to go about it. As old as Plato, Plato stated in those times that belief was something that people believed that the earth was flat. But how did the word faith come? I'm not going to touch on religion. Faith comes when you convert your belief into something that you suddenly look upon something with something that has influenced you to believe it. Influence has a lot to play with faith. Psychology has also shown that the human being gets influenced, and through this influence he develops his faith. In today's modern world, it is one of the most common tactics used in the advertising field, where we develop a product and advertise it in such a manner that people begin to have a faith in the product because of the influence of that advertisement. So influence is very, very important when it comes to creating a faith. This influence can also come from, in religious matters, from various books or traditions that have come down through centuries and generations. It can also come through family traditions and can come through scriptures, can come through many other things. But all of them point in one direction, and that is to influence your belief, to convert it into faith. So belief is very important, which is a natural instinct in us, which actually makes us who we are and gives us what we call the common sense. We develop this common sense by the time we are 18 years old. But under the influence of various things and experiences in our life, we then develop faith based on the influence of other matters that are coming in our life on a day-to-day basis. It's also been shown to us that if we are shown that we are medically told that we are incapable of having faith of our medical abilities, we would completely destroy ourselves. It's our faith that we have within ourselves, in our body, to be able to survive all the sicknesses that we have, and to power the healing power, to cure ourselves. It's the faith that we develop. The doctor helps us develop that faith within ourselves and convert our belief into faith that we will one day get cured of whatever our sicknesses are. It could be short, it could be long, it could be true, it could be false. But that faith will always be there, because there is a connection between you and the doctor, and the doctor and you. Faith also in religion is an important aspect, where people do follow things with reason and follow things without reason. They just follow things because their parents have followed it and their grandparents have followed it. But most of them today want to know why. And all religions can explain, but people have to have a broad mind to understand why and how things are done. There is a benefit in everything that religion tells us, but it is up to us to find that benefit. So I think that belief, whether that the earth is flat or that the earth is round, and the faith that 7 billion people have now that the earth is round, and that the faith that each one of us has, and each one of us has a common sense, clearly directs us to differentiate between belief and faith. We cannot live without belief. We cannot live without faith. But we have to always learn how to live with the coexistence of belief and faith. Many times we have a moral argument among ourselves that we may not believe in this, but we don't have faith in that. And the reason for that is because we fear to move from belief to faith. And that fear is because we lack the influence that we are looking for to convert our belief into faith. Once we get that influence, we very easily move from our belief to our faith. Once we have that faith, we've crossed that bridge forever. But from faith, can you go back to belief? Of course you can. You can always go backwards as well. Just like you go forwards from belief to faith, you can also go back from faith to belief. I'll give you an example how you can go back from faith to belief. Well, you have a lot of faith in your children, but you always believe that they will do something right. But still, you have to keep checking and seeing that what you are believing is actually what's happening. So yes, while you trust your belief, you have to keep checking your trust. Belief is something that you believe. Forget all this. Come into the story of love. You believe you're in love. When do you start having faith in your love? You start having faith in your love only when you see the influence of that love on you, that you start feeling the faith in that love. But you start with the belief that you believe you are in love. But it's only later that you begin to have the faith in the love, when the love has been proven to you and shown to you that you are truly and surely in love. Thank you.